I am guessing that the Florida State strength and conditioning program will not have a similar diet for one Lamont Green out of the 2023 class. Weak side defensive end, 6'4", 210 out of Gulliver Prep in Miami, Florida, Logan.
Yep. Is this the 2024 guy?
This is 2023. Lamont Green, obviously, he's coming as a defensive end. His dad was a member of the national championship team in 99. We're not going to lose our minds over it. It's a 2023 commit. 24/7 doesn't have any stars. They haven't released their commitments yet. He'll be a junior this year in high school. But it's a good thing as far as the look. It's a legacy commit. We've talked about this before. James has talked about this before. It's good to get guys who grew up in Florida State families coming back to Florida State. You know, you had Stanford Samuel come in. His dad, obviously, a former cornerback. But then you had Devin Bush leave down here in Pepper Pines, go to Michigan. You've had both of Bradley Jennings' kids. One went to Miami, one signed with Michigan. So it's good to get somebody coming in to
down here. I think Jennings actually ends up going and went to Maryland, which is absolutely hilarious. Hilarious.
It was committed to Michigan. I apologize. He went to Maryland.
But I'm pointing out that he went to Maryland. about as silly as it gets.
The bag talks sometimes. The money bag talks.
Sometimes it does.
But you're more into this recruiting from that aspect. I've seen him play down here in Miami. He's a good kid, good size. Yay or nay? How much should we be happy about this commitment from Lamont Green Jr.?
Well, it's big because you're able to grab a legacy commit that far in advance in the 2023 class. That means that Norvell is connecting well. Also, I mean, Lamont Green Sr. was pushing very hard for his son to come to Florida State. That wasn't like a thing where like, hey, you know, if you want to go to UF, you could do that. We're actually having Lamont Green Jr. and his senior on our podcast tonight, but I've overheard him senior talk about his son and him saying, you know, if he went to Florida, I would spank him. It's just like there's two different kind of fathers out there that are rep their alumni. One is pushing you hard to go to Florida State or go to a college that they went to, or they're really open up and, you know, go where you'd like to go. You know, we've seen James Coleman come on here and say, you know, if my son wants to go to Florida State, most certainly you do you. If he wants to go to LSU, you do you. But when it comes to Miami, things get a little bit more different. Lamont Green Senior, I know, is very big and probably connecting well with the staff at Florida State. But this kid is 6'4", like you said, 210, still got to work on some building, but he's young. This is 2023 class. So that body is going to come into shape. He's got a nice frame on him. And, you know, he's been putting out some videos of him working out. And he seems like a good kid, like you said, Jason. It's just good to grab these legacy guys that are also talented and down there in Miami too. You grab a Miami guy. You've been talking about these Florida kids, Jason.
I will give Norvell credit. I will give the recruiting staff credit on this one. It's getting a South Florida commit. It's getting, you know, Gulliver Prep is a big school. Patrick Robinson, former Florida State cornerback, came out of Gulliver Prep. The late Sean Taylor, arguably one of the best safeties in the history, former Miami Hurricane, came out of Gulliver Prep. It's a very good program. You know, and South Florida showed their power this last season when, you know, not a lot of these schools played full schedules and you still had, you know, six teams make it to the state championship game and five of them won titles. So, you know, I hate to say it. I know people in the Panhandle, people in Orlando don't want to hear it. High school football still runs through Miami-Dade and Broward County.
Yep. Now it's nice. And that's what Florida State right now is trying to focus on right now. Norvell and the staff is doing a very good job of getting these guys that are definitely legacy commits, but getting closer with alumni. And it's just these little steps. It's going to take patience. It's going to take definitely on the field production. It's got to be better on the field. But right now, Florida State is churning.